We're now joined by a special guest, Sifu Amsu. He's Northern Star and also now is the promoter of the Weapon Sparring. Sifu Su, welcome to Kung Fu Theater.
Thank you.
Sifu Su, you had the show. You come onto the show before. I'm sure that you're really familiar with your background. And I would like to ask you, what led you, you know, to start the Weapon Sparring?
So, almost all the Kung Fu schools, they practice weapon.
Mm-hmm.
And nowadays, I would say 90% or more so-called weapon training is only doing their form.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I do agree the form is very beautiful, elegant, enjoyable to watch.
Mm-hmm.
I do like to watch it. But sometimes you feel really kind of empty.
Mm-hmm. Okay,
because if we don't do the usage, mm-hmm. we don't do the sparring, there's no way we can understand what's the meaning contents in the movement.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I feel there's a need here before it's totally lost.
Mm-hmm.
We should try to start to promote the weapon sparring to encourage people when they do the weapon training, not only the form,
mm-hmm.
but start from the basic, then the form, and eventually usage.
So in the Chinese martial art, you mentioned about the weapons, mm-hmm. the basic. Actually, it's the same as the hand, right? You know,
yes.
The basic first, right?
Exactly. Right. Yeah.
So when you do the weapon, mm-hmm. how do you train your student to do that? Do you do basic first? Or?
Yes. We always start from the basic training,
mm-hmm.
Do the solo practice,
mm-hmm.
okay, chopping, thrusting,
mm-hmm.
okay, and so forth. And then we also do the two-person practice, but not the two-person pre-arranged form.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but one as a helper and one practice to do the movement to make sure the basic usage is right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then of course we switch.
You know, some people, when you mention about weapon sparring, people scare weapons, right? They think they get cut, you know, like mm-hmm. even just like sparring. People scared, wow, sparring, I don't want to do that, I just want to do for help.
Yes.
So how do you come across that?
Okay, first of all, when we do the weapon sparring, we don't use weapon. We don't use real weapon, we don't even use the wooden weapon. Okay? Right now what we're using, the weapon in the sparring, okay, it's made of bamboo and rattan,
mm-hmm.
and also very safely wrapped.
Mm-hmm.
And also we're still looking for other different kind of a design,
mm-hmm.
okay? So first of all, we are not using a real weapon like the ancient time in a battlefield mm-hmm. to kill each other.
Right.
Secondary, we do have a protection gear.
Oh, okay.
Okay, the head gear, chest protector, sling guard, and so forth. And number three, the weapon sparring is so-called the semi-contact sparring.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's not try to use your weapon to knock your opponent 10 seconds,
right.
and then you win the game.
So actually pretty safe.
Yes, I would say that's safer than the bare hand sparring.
Right, okay, now I get a better idea.
Yeah.
What kind of a benefit, I mean, you know, by doing the weapon sparring, you said you can be the tactical, right?
Yes, yeah. So we can gain more understanding about the form,
mm-hmm.
About the weapon, mm-hmm. no matter sword, spear, what we're using. Secondary, I do agree when you do the form practice, you do a solo form, it's helpful to your health,
mm-hmm.
to maintain a good health. But the two-person sparring is a totally different world.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, because when we do a solo, when we do a form, we can do whatever we want. We can stop anytime we want. We can do in any pace we feel comfortable with.
Right, right.
But two-person sparring is totally different.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you have to face the opponent. You have to be able to protect yourself and attack the target. You have to react, interreact.
Right, right. Okay.
So no matter physically or mentally, it's more beneficial.
Right. Is it all the, what the thing about the age? You know, some people do it like young, or what's the age?
That's a very good point. Allow me to compare with the bare hand sparring one more time.
Mm-hmm.
The bare hand sparring mostly just the young and strong people, they could do it.
Right.
Okay? The weapons really different.
Yeah.
People might start at a very young age, like 10 years old.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, they can participate in a tournament, they can win a trophy, they can spar with each other until, how about say, age 65. You know, 65 okay. is a retirement age. Okay,
right.
You're going to retire from your position, no matter you will serve as a executive in a company or a teacher in school.
Right.
You should retire now at 65, but you don't have to retire from the weapons sporting competition.
Right, the same thing, you know, in Japan in the kendo competition, they have some
exactly.
older
exactly. Yes, I saw some of them 70 years old, they are still swimming there. A sword competing with each other. Yes.
What do you think about the future of the weapon sparring?
I think it's very good.
Mm-hmm.
It's this is undeveloped frontier.
Mm-hmm.
Like this year, we do have a couple of tournaments scheduled,
mm-hmm.
Both in East Coast and West Coast.
Mm-hmm.
And also, that's an inter martial arts style weapon sparring organization
mm-hmm.
is forming.
Okay.
It's very interesting. Including some Japanese style, Korean style, Filipino style, and of course Chinese style.
So that means this weapon sparring allow any style to compete or to participate?
In the future, yes, I would
right.
say so.
Mm-hmm.
I would say so.
Oh, that's good. Now you have some student with you to demonstrate how to use the weapon, right? So let's check it out then.
Oh, okay. Thank
right.
you. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a sword. Oh yes, and wooden sword for practice. Okay, I'm going to use this sword to do some technique with my coach, Dr. Vari Lee, so to give you some idea about the sword usage training. We're going to start from the basic technique first. To save time, I'm not going to do the solo, but with Ms. Lee to show you some basic sword usage thrusting and chopping. Now should we start? Okay. From our demonstration, I think you can get an idea. The Chinese saw, when we do the thrusting, the movement is actually a curve. Okay, left or right, in and out curve. It should not straight. Now, let's see the chopping movement. Okay, you see? Right. Also, on our demonstration, I believe you can find out the chopping movement is not a straight chop. Just like a thrusting, the sword is always moving in a curve line, either left or right side. Okay, I believe this is a very basic difference than other martial arts sword usage. In Chinese sword, we always try to do the full day, use the sword, the full body from the tip, the middle portion, and the row, what we call. Okay, now we're going to show you some of the basic usage technique. Fundamentally, the Chinese sword usage, we divided into two different portions. One we call licking. Like in raining day, if the house is too old or too much rain accumulate, and then starting to lick. We should be able to try to find the enemy's lick and at the same time to fix our own lick. The another category we call it sticking, which means you should always stick with your enemy. Your position, your step, and very importantly, your sword. Okay, we will show the licking movement first. Okay, like so, go one. Two, three, four, like this. A very simple movement. But from those two, three movements, I think we can get some idea about what is so-called the licking technique. First of all, when an attack coming toward you, what we should not do is to block attack like that. okay? Or like this. Like what you saw in a Kung Fu movie or the Round Table Knights, that kind of fighting, okay? A Kung Fu sword technique to do, first of all, you shift your body to duck away, to hide the target area, and also to try to find a leak in this kind of situation, which means her rest. So I'm gonna cut her rest. Of course, she's gonna hide away, and what she's going to do is she find another leak. That's my head, upper portion of my body. So she's gonna attack my head. Certainly, I'm gonna shift away, hide away from this attack, and at the same time to find a leak is here. Her wrist again. Okay? Then I'm still going to hide away and attack my lower portion, which is my leg or my knee area. Okay, when this kind of attack come in, I will hide away, first of all, remove my leg, hide away from the attack, and use my sword to cut her wrist, like so. Yes, she hide away. But look at this. This is a very good, clear picture to show. She presenting a big leg here. So I might conclude the fight with the attack to her rib area. And this is what we mean, leak, fix the leak, find the leak. Another category we just mentioned was sticking. Oh yes, we even discussed earlier. When we do the weapon form practice, it's very pretty. Some of the movement may be, let me see, like this. Some of the movement may be like that. Yes, it is pretty, but what's the meaning? What's the real usage content in this kind of beautiful movement or posture? Okay, let's just use those two movements to show some of the sticking technique. Okay, also at the same time, we can explain what is in there behind those beautiful postures. Assuming the first one, you're still gonna attack me in my heart area, the middle portion of my body. Then again, we shouldn't do it like this. To cross like that. In a Kung Fu sword usage, what we should do, we will welcome and receive this attack. This is a receiving movement, and stick with it. Don't let it go away, and move my leg to get closer to your target and do the cutting like so. So isn't this the movement what you just saw? Yes. Second one, if your attack come in a little bit higher toward your higher portion, okay, to your face, your throat area, then again, we should not do the blocking like this or like that. Okay, that can open the door for 10 or 20 exchange attacking each other. Okay, in a Kung Fu sword technique, what we're gonna do is like this. When the attack comes, you receive it like so. Receive the sword and stick with it. Still stick with it, don't lose each other. And then you go up, and then you can do the chopping like this. One more time, your whole movement, go. Like so. The last movement in the whole practice, probably what we're gonna do is like this. But without the real understanding about the usage, the beautiful posture is just going to be an empty shell.
All right, thank you so much for coming to Kung Fu Theater.
Thank you.
Come to Kung Fu Theater. Now we know more about the weapons part. All right, that's good. Now we're back to the movie, The Super Gang.